Hey everyone, welcome to another episode of the SDFC Fancast.
Woo! Oh yeah.
That's a great intro song.
I feel like you guys knew what was coming up next, and I did not. I did not know what is that from.
Oh, that's Andrew WK, baby. That's a great song.
All right, what song is that?
Party Hard, I think. Right?
Is that the intro? Is that how Party Hard starts?
I get wet.
That's right. I get wet.
So sorry, everybody. I will be coughing and things like that. I am sick, so we're gonna keep this very short. But we had to post something. Because there is some news, but before we get to that news, a quick personal update from anybody. Keegan?
Not too much. Had a good weekend. There is one little thing though, of someone who's missing at the moment. Colin. Remember last week we were talking about those night airsoft games he was playing? We kind of joked about the bear, make a good movie. Well, as of 9:30 mountain time last night, he's been lost. There's search parties in the woods searching for him right now. So prayers and our hopes to Colin.
We're going to fight against the bear. Yep, we're going to set up a GoFundMe. We'll post it under the, you know, as a link in the YouTube. Keegan very well said, yeah, he's my dear brother. He always carries bear spray, but you know, that nighttime airsofting it's dangerous. It's dangerous up there. So, you know, we wish him prayers, thoughts and prayers. We wish him the best and, you know, just hope he has the will
to play dead.
Yeah. What's the Leonardo DiCaprio movie with the bear?
Oh,
yeah. Revenant.
The Revenant. Yeah. Colin is living the Revenant right now.
Have you guys ever rewatched that after you watched it for the first time?
Yes. I've only seen it once.
You have rewatched it, Keegan.
A couple times, yeah.
Okay, so after I watched it for the first time, and since I have to be different than everybody all the time, because I'm a little bitch like that, I was like, I think that Tom Hardy was a better character, did a better acting job than Leonardo DiCaprio in that movie.
Yeah.
How do you feel after watching it a few times?
In a way, I kind of agree. Tom Hardy's like the best side character in everything he does. That guy's amazing. But I thought it was good. The joke about Leo at that movie is he's a vegetarian, and to get an Oscar, had to force himself to eat because there's like a real liver he was biting into or whatever in that movie to get his Oscar.
That's just a popularity contest, right? I mean, it's like,
yeah. But yeah, no, Hardy's great, but I. Like you, I love Tom Hardy and everything. Like,
and also Domhnall Gleeson, the ginger mm-hmm. in it, dude. He is like, after watching him in Ex Machina and all that, and he's in some episodes of Black Mirror or an episode of Black Mirror that I know of. He's like one of my favorite actors. He's like good in everything I've seen him in, and I loved him in Revenant as well.
Yeah, that's right. He was very good. It's a good movie, but
Abdominal.
Domhnall Gleeson, and Julie just leaned over and she was like, he was in Harry Potter. So was he the twins? No way.
He was the twins.
When they're older, when they get older. The oldest brother.
He was Bill Weasley.
Remember the one who gets the dragons?
Oh,
and he's married to that one girl and then they die.
So Bill actually works at Gringotts, Keegan. It's Charlie who works with the dragons. Oh, and Bill is married to
Can we talk more about my missing brother? I mean, Jesus Christ.
Yeah, Colin's missing when we're arguing about Harry Potter.
Not this time.
Thanks for asking, Nate. I had a great weekend.
I was just going to tell Keegan, speaking of Harry Potter, I am on to the final battle of Hogwarts Legacy. I'm almost done with it.
No way.
Yeah. Sorry, Chris. Go
well done. Go ahead.
Anything off the trolley, Diz?
Oh, my God.
I love
Anyways,
it.
yeah, my weekend was great. Labor Day, whole thing, school's back. All right. Hey, SDFC made a signing and a very, very exciting one. Nate, you want to chat about Alex Mighten? I hope I'm
Yes,
pronouncing that correctly.
you are. It's Alexander Cole Mighton. That's his whole name. And he is, I'm excited. I mean, he has come up through Nottingham Forest Academy. And I remember when he got loaned out to another team. I think Sheffield Wednesday, I believe. And Steve Cooper was pissed. He was a coach of Nottingham Forest. I don't know if he still is. But yeah, dude, Steve Cooper was loaned him out so he can get some minutes. And then the coach of Sheffield never played him. And it was just like everyone was like, what the hell, dude? This is like the most exciting prospect like Nottingham Forest has had in a lot of years and all that stuff. So that was the first time I'd heard his name was in those regards. But after looking it up, it's just like, is this just another signing from out of the blue by old Tyler Heaps? I think it is, dude. I'm pumped on it. What do you guys think?
I was watching highlights first and foremost, and he's super exciting. He's very explosive on the wing.
Fast.
I didn't realize he was a US native. He's a dual citizen of England and US, so he might be a USA prospect somewhere down the line, which will be cool to root for US men's national team guy potentially. I don't know who he represents currently. I think he was playing with the England under 20s or something like that a couple years
He
ago.
he's played for England's under team ever, like in every single stage, which is incredible. Like you like I like every single stage, like under, I don't know the name, that's why I'm not naming them off. But if you look at him up, he's played in the England unders everything. So like he clearly has potential at the minimum, right? Like he's been scouted before.
Yeah, and watching the highlights, he just like he'll like burn two guys like it's nothing, or he'll juke two guys like it's nothing. Like he's a very exciting. I mean, even just if he did play for the US men's national team, he would be a huge addition for us because like outside of Pulisic and maybe Tim Weah, we don't really have that like true winger style guy who can, you know, juke people and get in the box and make things happen. So he's really exciting.
Yeah, no, I'm pumped on it.
Yeah, I'm just like checking him out right now, looking through. Yeah,
Oh, you
I'm
did your
stoked.
research. Nice.
There's a lot of upside, and to get a fast winger too, that especially he's playing in England, like even if he's playing on the under 20s, but it's England, that's huge. Like, yeah, obviously it's quality.
Well, yeah,
So,
thanks for checking my text. I was just gonna say he got loaned out to Norchland.
I was just yep.
Yeah. Well, no,
That's funny. Yeah, so
So he's gonna be playing with fucking Keegan. Just checked my text right now, mid live podcast. Anyways, yeah, he'll be playing with Ingvardsson and Jeppe. So we have, you know, the core of our team essentially already playing together and gelling and shit before the season starts. It's a huge advantage for an expansion team. I'd be very surprised if any expansion team ever had anything like that, where their two, you know, their striker, their winger, and their central midfielder are all already playing together and building chemistry. It's a brilliant move. And that just goes back to the Right to Dream Academy, just having that, you know, level of support where you could just ship people off to Norseland and let them train together until we, you know, are dialed in next year. It's pretty cool.
it's pretty nice that this, you know, San Diego MLS team is getting players that are good enough to play for a team that has historically been in the Champions League pretty regularly and stuff like that. It's fucking kind of crazy. Yeah, cheat codes. Them cheat codes are working, you know.
And Mighton was playing for, I don't know how much playing time he was getting, but not Nottingham Forest is a Premier League club, right? So having a Premier League talent come over to us is great, as opposed to, you know, a championship or I don't know, some sub-level division.
Yeah, no, absolutely. And what's cool as well, like kind of curtailing into the other news or the other rumor, which was who the coach would be, but like Mighton, like as you said, is a dual citizen. He was born in Connecticut. So I wonder when he got scouted, You know, it's got it like because he played for England's under everything in the youth system all the way up. Like, is he starting to train with the US men's national team a little bit? Like, is that how we saw him? Because the rumor is that SDFC is getting Mikey Varas, who is the current interim head coach of the US men's national team. I was just reading an article posted like 6 or 7 hours ago where he talks about he's going to pick the roster and it's only based off how the players perform in the camp right now. So SDFC just signed Mighten, who is a dual citizen. Tom Bogert, I think, is the one that kind of announced on Twitter that SDFC is looking at Mikey Varas, or somebody did. And he Mikey Varas has gone up through, you know, the US team. He coached our US team in the with the Olympics or whatever. I posted a comment because someone was talking shit. Someone was like, who the fuck is this guy? This and that. And I was like, well, he's the guy that took our team. We literally won our group, won our first game, then lost to eventual winners of Uruguay 2-0 in a pretty, you know, we were close. It was 1-0 most of the match and all that stuff. So it's like, dude, I'm down. Like, I'm down. I don't think the thing that I think of right away in regards to a coach, like, okay, maybe people don't know his name. I think Arsene Wenger went from the Japanese league straight to Arsenal. And I don't know if you guys know this, but Arsenal
Wow.
is the team that went undefeated in the Premier League. So I don't know.
Yeah,
Chris?
one of the greatest coaches of all time, Arsene Wenger. So, no, I'm stoked if that is the announcement that we're gonna hire Mikey Varas. I'm pumped. I'm in. It's no Jurgen Klopp, but we'll take it.
Yeah, that'd be great. And yeah, with coaching too, like if he's involved with the men's national team and everything, he's used to wrangling, not like egos, but big players, you know, but not compared to English teams, but he's obviously good working in that environment. So with a new team with a lot of guys, he might be a good person to get everybody on the same playing field. And with if he's choosing players, at least for the national team, based on camp and not prior playing experience, not experience, but just quality. That's great for us because we get everybody, and then who knows, we get guys who no one really knows that well from out of the country and everything, but they play well in the SDFC camp. He might be the guy to formulate a good team based on, you know, how they actually play rather than their names and status. So that'd be great.
Yeah, no, I think that's the right approach for a new team. If you're not, I don't know, if you're not some piece of shit up in LA, like, and you actually have to develop a team and not just get the biggest superstars, and you actually like soccer, you know, you don't like to go to a game to, I don't know, see 100 movies and all that, movie stars and all that shit. I think this is the right approach,
Nate, are you
personally.
crying? Are you crying?
Ava agrees with me. That was her just being like, fuck LA.
No, it looked like your beautiful blue eyes were tearing up.
Oh no,
Probably
I
just
know,
'cause you're
dude.
sick.
I'm sick and all my sinuses are just doing a good job. And like I've noticed re-watching the episodes, my face is always red. And people always think like I'm inebriated. But the fact of the matter is that my face is sweating. It's hot in here. That is all.
Getting hot
So
in
when
here.
wintertime comes, my face won't be as red.
Who thinks you're inebriated?
I do. When I look at it, if I were to look at somebody and who's doing a podcast and their face was red, I'd be like, that fool is fucked up.
That's probably what people think about me then.
But another signing that we have, oh, Charles Lozano scored again for freaking PSV, dude. Okay, on the Liga MX.
There's a quality goal too. I don't know if you guys saw it. It was a
On the
steal.
League MX subreddit, do you know what the title of it was when they posted that goal, Chris? Do you want to know? Do you want to guess? The title of it
SDFC's
was,
forward scored for PSV.
nope, it was, what is this guy cooking?
Nate, that term has been around for a long time, by the way.
Chris, I was complaining about it being used incorrectly. Now it's used in every single facet because when you cook up
Oh,
something,
here we
yeah, that's been
go.
used for a long time. I explained this on the last time.
I'm gonna go join Colin with the bear. This
You're
is
gonna go
bad
look for
enough.
him?
Hey, what if the camera then pans and Colin is in a kitchen and the guy from the bear is just them with a pan? I don't
Jeremy
know.
Allen White or whatever his name is.
I don't know. I've never
It's
seen that show. I just thought
a
about
really good
that.
show, highly recommended.
All right. Corners. That's what I heard. That's what I hear. But no, that's, I mean, do you guys, I don't know of any other news. Y'all know of any other news besides our players are good and we're building a badass team and all that shit?
No, it's just nice to have another signing, right? Like did that come? So that was Friday. So that was still while the transfer window was open. Does that mean we're probably not going to be making any other signings until January?
Dude, I have to look up the different transfer windows because, like, I think Italy's transfer window is still open. There's still like a few transfer windows still open. Strangely, Saudi Arabia's is still open, I believe. And I think that that's a place where we should be looking at players. Like, if somebody has been there for a year and they're unhappy or something like that, which there has been a lot of that, maybe we can get them on a cheap. You know what I'm saying? So, I am not well versed enough to give you a definitive answer, but I don't think that it's I don't think that transfer windows for different leagues are at the same time. So I think that there is potential for potentially getting other people, but don't quote me on that.
I wonder if there's like a loophole because we're an expansion team and we're not actually a team yet. I wonder if there's a way to come to an agreement to terms with other teams, but not actually have them transfer out. Like, for example, like let's say we're going to make a deal for, I don't know, hypothetically, Christian Pulisic and AC Milan. Like, can we say, okay, SDFC plans to sign him? They've agreed to terms for when the January transfer window has opened and he's going to keep playing out until, January. I wonder if that's a way how it can work. I don't know. It seems like it could be a way. Like, I feel like I've seen that before where like big names have, that they're on the way out once the transfer window opens. You know what I mean?
Absolutely. No, I have to imagine that there are times like that. And I think that's what the tipping up, as they call it, right? In Europe and stuff like that. Like, you can't, there's rules where you can't, like, I don't know what the rules are. I know that Chelsea has broken these rules in the past. It has been fined. And there's literally been three transfer windows since I've been watching Chelsea since 2005, that Chelsea was not allowed to sign players because of rules that they broke in regards to tapping players up. So, and I think it was Mourinho talking to players who are on another team and convincing them to come here. But I don't know where the criteria is, because that isn't like, don't you need to go to players and like sell them on the project and all that stuff? Like, is there also a window where you can go talk to them? I don't know.
Yeah, because you think like at least, teams would be talking to a minimum like their agents and everything as well, like trying to see who
Maybe.
wants out, who's going to go. But I don't know if it goes as far as like they actually have a deal before the transfer market or if it's just kind of a handshake or something. Yeah.
But I feel like I'm
Gail
trying to figure.
Kakuta, that's the player, just so you guys know, that Chelsea got that caused a lot of drama. Gail Kakuta.
Just
Old
trying to
Gail.
think of examples like. Didn't Messi, for example, didn't had he already agreed to join Inter Miami while he was still with Barcelona? Like, wasn't that a thing? Like, it was in
PSG,
the, or PSG, I'm sorry,
I
PSG.
don't, dude, that's the thing is, I don't know. That
I
feels
just,
correct, right? Like, it feels like a player should be able to be like, hey, this is the team I'm gonna go to next. I ain't signing a contract
Trev,
this year.
jump in the chat
Yeah.
here. What I mean, you're the smartest guy in the room. What are we dealing with here? But yeah, I mean, either way, I guess I'm just putting it out there that we can still get more signings prior to, January or even the December draft and all that. So I don't know. I guess it's just kind of wishful thinking.
But it also,
I just hope Mighten wasn't
I think you're
our
right.
last signing for the next 3 months, aside from potentially a new head coach soon, hopefully.
Hey, dude, yeah, Tyler Heaps, that's the thing he said in his interviews. He just keeps saying, hey, watch, we're gonna be pumping out news. And since then, we did sign Mighten and all that stuff. So
Yeah, I mean, he officially got announced, what, I think it was like the 16th of August, and we already made a signing on the 30th. Pretty cool. So exciting. Mr. Heaps, big
as I
fan.
put in the
Yeah.
chat, my man crush on old TJ Heaps just grows daily. You know, I
I
think
can't
he's
wait
got
till
it.
I can't wait till you meet him and you just melt because you're such a Chelsea whore.
I don't think he's affiliated with Chelsea.
He came from Chelsea though, didn't he?
Monaco. Tyler Monaco. Heaps.
Who else came from Chelsea? Sorry, you said something about Chelsea signing like.
Oh no! So Gale. I was just talking about in regards to the like the rules, like you were talking about, is Chelsea has been punished for tapping players up.
No, it wasn't that. This was about our like a text message. Doesn't matter. We can move on.
I mean, maybe the national team coaches with Emma Hayes and then Pochettino is supposed to be. So literally, in the article,
that's what it was. It's because we got Pochettino as the U.S. men's national team. That's what it was. Okay, thank you.
Hey, and it talks about Mike Ybarra. He's the current interim, and there he's just waiting for Pochettino to get signed. So that's fucking sick, dude. That's going to be – that's what Tom Bogert said. That's who's going to be our coach. So,
wow.
Not me. You didn't hear that from me. You heard that from old Tom Mustachioed Bogert. Okay. But no, I think that's it. That's it for news. We can do – I mean, Colonial's not here. We can do a quiz game. It is topical. For just this evening, if you guys want, and it's not going to count, we can run through it real quick. It's up to y'all.
Let's do it.
Let's go.
Okay.
It's only a game. Why do you have to be mad?
So glad we have that on the drop now.
So tonight's quiz game is on Vicks VapoRub.
Oh, topical indeed. I was wondering what you were snorting this whole episode.
It's also topical because that's when you see players with that weird patch on their chest. That's what they have rubbed on is Vicks VapoRub.
Interesting.
Yeah. And what's also interesting, never mind. We'll Keegan bring that up at another time.
Keegan uses that for lube, but yeah, anyway, that's all.
speaking of VapoRub, as Keegan gets high off his Sharpie.
All right. I love that with Chris Farley when never mind. He's on the quiz show.
Hachi Jew Hachi. Yeah.
There it is.
Oh, the embassy. All right.
Yeah.
Which company makes Vicks VapoRub? Is it Johnson & Johnson, Vertex Pharmaceuticals, or Procter & Gamble? The answer is Procter & Gamble.
Shit.
Keegan's going to win this one.
When it doesn't count.
I know.
That's why. I know. What year was Vicks VapoRub first sold? 1901, 1903, 1905.
I like how you've added three to the mix instead of just two. That's a good call.
Was it
Tommy Likey? Tommy want wingy.
Was it 3-5? 1-3-5.
1-3-5.
1-3-5.
Okay.
I'll give you a hint. The answer is a prime number. Okay. It's not a prime number. It's 1905. You can divide it by five.
Jesus.
All right. When they tested putting Vicks directly onto the throat of living beings, what animal was used for said testing? A pig, a rat, ferret.
Yeah, I love it. I love my little naughty pet. You're naughty.
We did not. Oh my God.
Oh, I love it.
Trev is the best soundboard guy in the game, just so you guys know.
Yes, he is.
So you guys know.
I'm so glad because I've heard the just you're naughty gif, or sound bite, but I haven't heard the whole thing. And the whole thing is so much better.
The answer is a ferret.
Ferret. Wow.
God.
I thought it would have been pig because pig's skin is more like humans.
Ferret. Thanks, Keegan. That's literally why I put pig in there. Thanks, dude.
Yeah.
You guys are so smart.
He's a son of a bitch.
What state was Vicks VapoRub originally manufactured in? North Carolina, South Carolina, or Georgia?
$20. I wanted a peanut.
Georgia peanuts. I like it. I like it. What is this, Jimmy Carter? All right, you guys ready?
Yep.
North Carolina.
Yeah.
I lose. Keegan has two. I haven't gotten one right. This is so uncharacteristic.
You were right, Chris, but it doesn't matter.
Yeah. We can do the last one, though, for fun.
All right. Yeah, let's hear it.
This is a 50-50 one. Is there more methanol or is there more eucalyptus in Vicks VapoRub?
Oh, wow.
I have to look because for this one, I didn't write the answer for some reason. Pretty sure it's methanol.
It's methanol.
It's methanol.
Oh, I thought that was the obvious choice, so I wrote eucalyptus. That's the first time I've gone 0-5, and I think maybe ever. Wow.
Dang.
Thank God it didn't count. Thanks, brother, getting mauled by a bear.
As Colin's crawling all wet in the forest.
I'm like, eucalyptus.
He's like, the night vision did nothing.
Yeah, it makes yeah. They're attracted to it. All the bears like come down.
Well, Nate, you haven't made a run in a while. Do you want to make a run?
Oh, when I'm sick? Okay. Slowest run of all time.
Michael Jordan flu game.
Oh, get it in there.
Oh boy.
Oh shit, this ain't basketball.
Did you just yeah. Oh boy.